Unity is merging with a company that created a malware installer, which made some noise in the community and worried many users. The problem with Unity is that they're now a public company, so they need to make enough money to please shareholders. That's more important than doing what's best for us, game developers. Don't get me wrong, it's still a very powerful game engine, of course, but the company has been investing more and more into things that can make them a lot of money. Mark Brown, the author of Game Maker's Toolkit, recently looked at Unity's latest acquisitions and partnerships. He measured how many improved game creation tools, and he found that there were only 3 out of 21. Many Unity users are now looking to switch, but switching can be a little daunting. Here are 2 common pain points. The first problem is the job market. There aren't as many jobs for most other engines. It's true, though that also comes with less competition. Then, the truth is, for many jobs, people care about your portfolio and experience making games. A strong portfolio with varied projects is much more valuable than experience with a specific engine. The second problem is that learning another engine also means that you need to learn a different workflow and language. You need to learn everything again. Yes and no, the code will change, but getting up to speed with a new tech is so much faster than learning the foundations. It will be a lot faster than you might fear. At the start, there will be a lot to take in, but it doesn't take long to become productive again. Learning a new engine or language is also great for you as a developer. It gives you new perspectives and makes the next switch much easier. Let's say that you're ready to try a new engine. Another challenge is picking one. There are many powerful tools. For 2D, there's Phaser, Default, or accessible ones like CTJS. For 3D, there's Unreal, of course, Heaps, the engine of Dead Cells and Northgard, or the Open 3D Engine, formerly Amazon's Lumberyard, which aims to support AAA games. There's another one that's been growing in popularity that does both 2D and 3D, the Godot Game Engine. We've been contributing to Godot since before it was even cool, and so we'd like to convince you to give it a try. Of course, the choice of engine stays up to you. You should try several options and pick the one that works best for you. But Godot has a lot of potential and may well meet your needs, especially with the upcoming version 4. Godot is the free and open source general 2D and 3D game engine with a fully fledged game editor, in which you can do everything down to coding. Because it's a free software project, it can never have the problems Unity currently has. Godot has no shareholders and isn't trying to make profits. Nobody owns it. It's all about game developers and engineers making great tools for fellow creators. Every week, the developers review proposals and contributions from the community. Development is very active and takes user feedback into account. Our team has been able to contribute some features that way. Now, let's say that someone comes and wants to buy Godot. It's highly unlikely that any developer would accept, but imagine they put billions on the table. Godot is open source, so even with all the money in the world, nobody can buy it. The community can fork it and keep going. This is great insurance for users like you and I. Godot has its cons right now, and we're not going to hide that. 3D currently isn't as powerful as Unity or Unreal, that's for sure. Though it's sufficient for many indie games, especially on mobile. Godot lacks a proper asset store. There's a free asset library, but it's not anywhere as big as Unity's. For console exports, you need to work with a third party like Lone Wolf or Pineapple Works. Performance isn't as good out of the box. You can't just throw 10,000 rigid bodies in a scene without any optimization. The good news is that most of these issues are being worked on right now. Godot 4 is getting a new and modern 3D engine based on Vulkan. There's a proper asset store in preparation, and a lot of work is going into performance optimization. Then, Godot has many strengths too. It is super lightweight with only a 50 megabytes download, and the editor opens blazingly fast. Running your game or individual scenes is also super fast. There's no compilation required in advance, meaning you can iterate quickly. The source code is yours and accessible, so you can fix issues yourself or pay someone to do it. We do that in our team, and other users also contribute. Godot has a small and simple language, GDScript, specialized for gameplay programming. The Unreal Engine is getting a scripting language too, as they are fast to learn and remove complexity in your daily work. But the good news is Godot also supports C# if you prefer. Finally, you can use even more languages like Rust, JavaScript, or C++ without recompiling the engine, thanks to its native script technology. Those are just a couple of highlights of what Godot can do for you. To try Godot, all you have to do is go to the official website, click download, and double-click the file. There's no installation. You'll find the link in the description. Then, we have great courses to get you started. Getting Started with Godot is a free series to get you up to speed with the engine. It's available both in text and video formats. If you don't have much programming experience, we also made a free and open source app you can use to learn Godot's scripting language. It comes loaded with interactive practices you can do right in your browser. If you want to learn even faster, we offer paid courses for beginners and experienced developers. If you are a beginner, Learn to Code from Zero with Godot is a comprehensive course that will teach you the foundations of game development. Unlike other courses, it comes with interactive exercises you can do in the Godot game engine to test what you learn directly. If you're an experienced developer, Godot Node Essentials is an extensive knowledge base about Godot's basic building blocks, the nodes. With over 100 demos, it'll teach you many ways to use the nodes in your games. It comes with a cheat sheet to quickly find exactly what you need and covers 2D, UI, and 3D. You'll find the links in the description below. With that, be creative, have fun, and I hope to see you in our next Godot tutorial on the channel. Bye-bye.